Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video, we'll be using the Photoshop Elements Elliptical Marquee Tool to create this rainbow metallic picture frame. Now, if you like this video, don't forget to hit that like button and, of course, click on share. Also, click on subscribe. I do a bunch of videos every single week. You can find more of those on my channel. And if you want to learn a lot more about using Photoshop Elements, the whole program, not just a few things I'll be doing here, take a look at my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. This Photoshop Elements Elliptical Marquee Tool picture frame is actually a very easy project, but there are a few little tricks you'll need to know to make this work out. Okay, I'll just close this one down. We'll start off brand new. I'll start off with a brand new file here, blank file, there it is. And I'll set this at the default Photoshop Elements size, which is 6x4 at 300 pixels per inch, which is your printing resolution. Choose OK, and there we go. Let's go ahead and dock that right there, and let's fit screen. Okay, let's now fill this with black. So black is my foreground color. Grab the paint bucket, click inside, and that fills that with black. We'll now go to the Photoshop Elements Elliptical Marquee Tool right there. I have my rulers set at pixels. If you right-click on the ruler itself, you can choose pixels right there at the top. There's your inches, there's pixels. If you don't see your rulers, go up to view and come down right here. There's your ruler. Just click on that. Come in about 100 pixels and 100 pixels, so right about here. Doesn't need to be exact, but just someplace around here. And then click and drag out the marquee. You can see it right there, and come down to about the same spot on the bottom right hand side. And just let go. And that makes our first elliptical marquee. Now we'll be using this a couple of times, so we need to save this selection. Go up to select, come down to save selection right here, and let's give this one a name. I'll just call it ellipse, which is fine. Choose OK. Okay, that's now saved, so we can easily come back to this. Let's just deselect that for the moment. There we are. Let's now make a new layer. There it is. Click on the new layer button right there, new layer. And then go up here to the gradient tool. Now in the gradients, you'll see all these standard default gradients. I just chose this rainbow gradient right there. It's on the basic set. So there we are. Make sure you're set at the left option down here, which is the linear gradient. Mode is normal, opacity is 100. Transparency and dither are both on, reverse is off. And then come up about here somewhere, and then drag down to about the same spot on the right-hand side. It gives you just a bit of a diagonal gradient like that. Let's now put this inside of that selection. We'll use our selection to create a layer mask. So let's bring our selection back up again. Select, load selection, and ellipse, there it is. Choose OK. There's our selection. Now click on the layer mask button, and here's our layer mask with that selection loaded. We're now going to make another ellipse inside of this ellipse and adjust the layer mask. So hold the Alt key down and click on the layer mask. That takes you inside of the layer mask itself. We can now reload our selection. So select, load selection, and again, there's the ellipse. There it is again. That's the selection that we made with the elliptical marquee tool right there. And you can see it right along the edge of that white. We're now going to change this selection a little bit. Go back up to select and come down to transform selection. This gives you control handles for your selection. Now take the left hand side and pull it in just a little bit, just a touch. Get the top one here and pull it in just a little bit further. So real small amount in there. Bring the bottom one up a bit further like that. And then grab the right hand side. You can see this little squares right there, right in the middle of each side. Grab that one, pull that one in a lot further. And that gives us this kind of offset ellipse in here. There it is. And then choose OK. So it's a real small left-hand side, almost non-existent, a little more at the top up here, and further on the right and on the bottom. Choose OK. Now I'm going to use my arrow keys on my keyboard and tap this over just a little bit to the right and down just a touch. I just want a thin little bit of space showing right along in here, just a little thin bit right in there. Okay, now let's fill this with black. So back to our paint bucket, click in here, that fills that with black, and there's our offset frame. Okay, select and then deselect, there it is. Now this is on our layer mask, so when we go back over here, we're going to see the rainbow inside of this shape. So click on the background layer, that just deselects that layer mask that we're in, and there's the basic frame shape. Now, let's make the glow in behind this. The glow is easy to do. Just go back up here to your frame layer, right click where it says layer 1, and choose duplicate layer, and OK. Gives you a layer copy up here. This will be our sharp edge layer. Come down here to layer 1. This will be the glow layer. Now for the glow, all we have to do is just blur that layer out. So go up to filter, come down to blur, and we'll use right down here the motion blur. And in here I have kind of an interesting little setting. I have my distance set at 100 pixels, and then the angle is set at negative 25 right there. It's kind of an angle like that, which kind of matches the angle up here. And you can see what happens. We don't have a whole lot of blur happening up along here. We have more blur happening right in here, and then more blur happening over here. So this motion blur gives us that blur in only parts of the curve here and not other parts. So kind of an interesting blur effect. And then choose OK. I'm just going to rename this layer down here, blur, so we know what we're talking about. There we go, there's our blur layer. Now on the blur layer, I'll be using the arrow keys on my keyboard to nudge that blur over a little bit. I want to nudge it to the right a little bit, and then nudge it down a little bit. And you can see what's happening. I'm making it so that there's more blur outside and just a little bit of blur inside. You can adjust the amount of that to suit, but something kind of like this, or just a little thin bit in here, and then a lot more blur on the outside. A little bit of blur showing up over here. This will be really hidden by the photograph. So there is the basic frame. Let's now bring our picture in. Come down here to the background layer. Now I already have one open, so I'll just go ahead and I'll use that one. That's right there. If you want to use this same picture just to work along with this, I have this as a download. There's a download link in the description. So take this image. If you don't have floating windows like this, go up to Edit, come down to Preferences and General, and right here, Allow Floating Documents in Export Mode is checked. There you go. I know I say that every single video practically, but it's not checked by default, so for anybody who hasn't seen my videos before, it's important to know how to do this one little trick in here. Okay, floating window. I can now grab this background layer here and drag it to my other file, and it's that easy to copy that image over. That's why I like that floating window. Now, let's just move her around till we get her position right. See, here's the top of the frame. I want to have that top in behind the frame up there. So right about there. It's about as low as I can go and not have the top showing. So that's a pretty good position in here. Now, I don't want to have her showing outside, so we need to bring back up that selection again. So select, come down to load selection, and then choose the ellipse again and choose OK. That loads that selection back in again. And then we'll use that for a layer mask on this layer. Just click the layer mask button. There's our layer mask, and that hides the outsides of that picture. Okay, all we have left to do is the metallic effect, and this is just a one-click effect. It's on our top layer up here where it says layer 1 copy. Come down to styles, and it's this option right here. We're in bevels. It's the top option. And the bottom of the bevels is this wacky metallic. Click on that, and there's that metallic effect. Like I said, just one click, and there's the effect. Okay, so there you go. Real fast, real easy, kind of an interesting looking picture frame. And again, the whole thing is really done just by using that elliptical marquee tool. And don't forget, if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and, of course, click on share and also click on subscribe. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. The link's right down there in the description.